So I've asked this question, 12-step related question, in relationship to food. What about the progressive nature of food? And if you pick up, it's going to be worse. And that is true within 12-step fellowships. If you if you're not working your program and you manage to white knuckle it for a while, and you pick up the food, it will come with greater ferocity. Or if you're in a 12-step program and you're dry drunk, and you pick up the food again, you know, using your willpower, it'll be more ferocious than last time. I think there is a thing in the big book about the alcoholic who he just worked really hard and used his willpower, retired, and then had a drink and then was dead very quickly. So just waiting in the background. What's very interesting with Dr. Hawkins, which he said, the big book is really relevant for 12-step fellowships and sort of atheists and whatnot coming in, who don't want to become saints or enlightened or transcend this world. It's just for people who just want to be free of the suffering of their addictions. So it's at that level of truth. It's not the level of truth for a saint or someone who wants to transcend the world. So, in that case, you have to keep working your program, your 12-step fellowship, to stop your addiction. And if you stop working or you do pick up, it's even more ferocious. Now, the reason that is it possible to transcend that, not need 12-step fellowships? Well, yes. But it usually doesn't happen within a 12-step fellowship. You'd actually need to reach the level of unconditional love, which is 540 on the scale of consciousness, Hawkins scale. Now, if you want to become an advanced spiritual seeker, and you get to 540, which is unconditional love, which is a very advanced, if you're 540 and above, you're starting to approach the realms of sainthood. So it's a real level of spiritual dedication. So the light of consciousness, the light of God, will start to shine very, very high within consciousness. So actually at that level, your energy field is more powerful than a 12-step meeting. So if your vibration is higher than a 12-step meeting, do you need a 12-step meeting any longer? No. Do you need to work the 12 steps any longer? No. Obviously, and God will direct your life to in whatever saintly duty you need now, because your level of advice, of course, everyone in 12-step fellowships is an aspiring Buddha or a saint. So they do need to keep working their program. And if they do pick up, it will often be more ferocious and more progressive, because a 12-step program is mostly just to halt the addiction and keep a level of spirituality going, but not to transcend food addiction and get to those very high advanced level of dedicated spirituality. So yes, what's actually happening in a 12-step program? Well, like alcoholics who kill themselves with alcohol, drug addicts who kill themselves with drugs, food addicts which kill themselves with food, relationship addicts which commit suicide out of relationship addiction, it's a progressive illness. So you lose at a certain point of selfishness. It's like the spiritual weight of the soul. It means you've lost the choice of using willpower any longer. You want to continue to be an atheist, agnostic, and not seek spiritual aid, then you've lost that choice of willpower. It's like you've lost that. There's the karmic merit, the spiritual privilege has been removed. And so you don't have the spiritual aid because you've denied God and you've been too selfish. So you'll just eat yourself to become more progressive, or take more alcohol, or take more drugs, and it'll progress and progress until you're dead and in levels of essential hell. So in a 12-step program, you're praying, you're meditating, you're trying to be helpful, your spiritual buoyancy, and you get a daily, you get a reprieve. You haven't yet transcended food, usually in a 12-step program, unless you're doing advanced spiritual work. So you get a reprieve, and you need to keep working your program, 12-step program, for good, because why would you stop? If you're not aiming to be a saint or a Buddha or a transcended teacher, why would you stop? Because you haven't yet transcended unconditional love. So you do need to keep that spiritual humility going on and keep a level of consistent work to keep your addiction at bay. And you live a very happy and spiritually directed life. So that's my views on that. I shall stop the